Hello, everyone. In recent months, three amateur astronomers and researchers tracing the length of deep space objects have discovered a massive structure made of ionized oxygen, nearly as large as the Andromeda galaxy. It's a little surprising that it's overlooked in this region when we're targeting all the giant telescopes and observatories we've pointed into space. Throughout history, the Andromeda galaxy has been photographed many times by both amateurs and space agencies, and extensive studies have been made about it. The fact that the huge structure formed on the galaxy, which is so popular, has been overlooked may be an opportunity for us to review what we know. Today, we will examine the Andromeda galaxy and the huge structure discovered on it. Let's start. Andromeda, the farthest celestial body visible from Earth with the naked eye, is 2.54 million light-years away. But don't worry, Andromeda is still on a collision course at 110 kilometers per second at around 400,000 kilometers per hour. Sorry, no escape. After about 4 billion years, the Milky Way will converge with Andromeda and all structures will scatter chaotically, creating a new system. You guessed it, such a collision would mean the end of our solar system. According to the models prepared for the collision of two galaxies, the Sun will be thrown 28,000 light years away with the effect of the collision. What a terrible ending! But don't worry, long before this collision, the Sun will run out of fuel and die by swallowing our planet. But for now, all is well, and we have many, many years ahead of us for the collision. Please share with us in the comments which apocalypse you prefer. Now that we talked about possible death scenarios, we can get back to our topic. Since Andromeda has been imaged repeatedly by Earth-based observatories and even the Hubble Space Telescope, astronomers assumed that all that would be discovered would be small, individual objects such as nebulae within the galaxy. But the huge nebula discovered by amateur astronomers made us forget what we knew. The researchers took this photo using a backyard telescope. They were obtained with the 111-hour long exposure method. With this method, the target object photographed for hours, sometimes even days. Then the obtained data is created by stacking and combining. For 40 of the 111-hour long exposure, the team used an ionized oxygen filter out of pure curiosity that blocked all light except the blue-green glow emitted by the double ionized oxygen. In this way, the huge structure near the galaxy emerged. Thinking at first that the nebula had emerged from a technical malfunction, the team asked another amateur astronomer, Bray Falls, to make observations, and his observations independently confirmed the existence of this structure. Eventually, observations from five telescopes in France, California, and New Mexico convinced the team that this object was real. The team named the nebula the Stratner-Drexler Sainte Object 1, or S2-1 for short. For detailed analysis of the nebula structure, the team reached out to professional astronomers Stefan Keimswinger, Michael Schull, Robert Fiesen. It turns out that this emission feature has never been reported in the scientific literature. Even multi-wavelength image studies such as ROSET in X-rays, GALAX in the ultraviolet, Planck, IRIS in the infrared, and STES in optics have not reported such emission from this structure. The results of this professional amateur collaboration, published in the Journal of the American Astronomical Society, are fascinating, though clues to the nebula's origins remain maddeningly obscure. Now that the gas cloud has been proven, what exactly is it? The nebula's structure resists many explanations, although astronomers consider many possibilities. Since it is adjacent to Andromeda, the nebula may be related to the galaxy. Even the structure is slightly curved, as if it were moving away from the galaxy. However, this does not physically connect the cloud to the galaxy. If so, one is indeed part of Andromeda, that means the cloud is tens of thousands of light years long, making it one of Andromeda's largest coherent structures. On the other hand, if the cloud is located in the galactic halo, which is a roughly globular collection of stars, it may be gas ejected by stellar streams there. But if it were, there would have to be an enormous amount of hydrogen around. As the hydrogen detecting filter shows, there is no hydrogen in the cloud, or at least too little to be detected. As we mentioned at the beginning of our video, Andromeda and the Milky Way are on a collision course. And there's about 2.3 million light years between the galaxies. Well, it's a pretty short distance on the galactic scale. So one is roughly between the two, which made us think of the possibility. Andromeda is so close to the Milky Way that the two galaxies may be interacting by bumping into each other as they transit through space. The diffuse gas in the two galactic halos would be compressed during the collision, forming a curved structure like the bow wave of a ship moving through water. But if that were the case, the cloud shouldn't have appeared so close to Andromeda. Instead, it should appear roughly midway in the sky between Andromeda and the center of the Milky Way. And this scenario still doesn't explain the hydrogen deficiency. Another possibility is that the cloud is physically much smaller, but much closer to us. A nebula that randomly appeared near Andromeda in the Milky Way. Planetary nebulae are shells of gas ejected by dying sun, like stars, and are often rich in hydrogen and oxygen. With the central star energizing the gas, these nebulae tend to appear bright in the light emitted by both elements. Thus, hydrogen deficiency in STEO-1 does not fit this possibility. It's possible that STEO-1 is the remnant of a Milky Way star that exploded as a supernova, but then it should have also glowed in ultraviolet light and radio waves. But astronomers studying ancient observations of Andromeda were unable to see anything coming from the cloud at other wavelengths, including X-rays, visible, and infrared light. It is surprising, if not entirely surprising, to astronomers that something this enormous has never been detected in our sky until now. Large telescopes tend to have a narrow field of view, so objects with large apparent size are difficult to observe. Even the filters and detectors used in professional observatories are designed to observe differently than amateur telescopes. This increases the difficulty of finding objects such as STEO-1. Even the 3.8 meters Canada-France-Hawaii telescope, equipped with an incredible 378 megapixel camera and oxygen filter, looked at STEO-1's spot in the sky and saw nothing. It's impressive equipment, but it wasn't designed to see something this big and faint in the sky. The researchers report that spectral observations are currently ongoing, but until they are gone, the origin and behavior of this cloud will remain a mystery. That's all from us for now. Which object in the sky would you like to explore? Please share your ideas with us. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. See you in another video.